Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Just a short prayer before we begin today's program. Father, we thank you for your word today. We give you all the glory, all honor, all adoration. Thank you for everyone that's here today. Thank you for everyone that's listening. Lord, let your word go. Let your word go with power. Let your word go with healing. Let your word go with authority. Bless every listener. Bless, heal every listener, everyone that's here, everyone that's watching on the internet, everyone that's listening. Meet them with your specific word. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. The Lord is good all the time. Amen. Before we go into the teaching for today, we're going to take a couple of songs. If you know it, just sing along. Let's just start with amen, amen. Blessings and glory, wisdom, thanksgiving, and honor, power and might be unto my God forever and ever. Amen. Amen, amen. Blessings and glory, wisdom, thanksgiving, and honor, power and might be unto my God forever and ever. Amen. I surrender all.
I'll sing I Surrender one more time.
I rain down on. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We give you all glory. We give you all honor. We give you all adoration. Release your Holy Spirit to take total control now. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord is good all the time. The Lord is good all the time. This is the last Sunday in the month of October 2012. In the month of September, tomorrow will be October 1st, but today is September the 30th, the last day in the month. So before we know it, 2012 is almost gone. We started a new year. So I believe that God will do everything He has designed to do for you in this year in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. For those that are watching me for the first time, we're teaching. These are scriptures pulled out of the Bible. This is our last teaching for the month, in the month of September, on healing. This is Healing School, and I advise you to get your copy of Healing Passports, Confessions that will bring, that will restore your health. Healing Passports, Confessions that will restore your health. We say God is good and He wants His children to be healed. He wants you to be healed. Maybe peradventure you're a child of God and you're struggling, you know, there's something going on. I want you to keep in, you know, be expectant, tune in your faith, believe to receive, and the word of God will go with power today and heal you. To make it easier, you know, this is a recommended book. It's on Amazon, I think $5.99, $6. Get a copy for yourself. It's on our website also. Get it for someone that you know that is, that needs a touch of God. The word of God is power, is healing virtues in the word of God. Amen. So I'm going to be, you know, this is a teaching ministry also. You know, we're going to be looking at today from Mark chapter 2, from verse 1 to 5. Mark chapter 2, from verse 1 to 5, taken out of the book Healing Passport. Or you have a Bible at home, you know, just go through with me. Amen. So he said, he entered Capernaum after some days, and it was heard that he was in the house. Hallelujah. Jesus is in the house. Hallelujah. Amen. Jesus is in the house. He's also in the house today. Amen. So it was heard that he was in the house. The Bible says immediately many gathered together. Amen. It was heard that he was in the house. Many gathered together. It says, so that there was no longer room to receive them, not even near the door. The villagers, they all ran and they came. The Bible says, not even near the door. The place was filled. Amen? And he said, he preached the word to them. You hear that same word today. He preached the word to them. And in verse 3 says, then they came to him. Guess what happened first? They first heard the word, right? And it says, they came to him bringing a paralytic carried by four men. So the Bible says there was this man. He was paralyzed, could not walk. He was on a stretcher, four men were carrying him. Remember what the Bible told us earlier? The whole place was jam-packed. Amen? It said, the verse 4 said they could not come near him because of the crowd. Hallelujah. There was a crowd everywhere. He could not get to the preacher. Who was preaching today? Savior Jesus. Wonderful Jesus. Healing Jesus. Because of the crowd, they could not get near him. Maybe the same way you are so afar off. But the word of God is available to heal you. Amen? Amen. So they now said, they uncovered the roof where he was. They said, we cannot get to this Jesus. But we need to get to him. Is there a roof? Yes. And they went to the roof. The Bible says they uncovered the roof. Open up the roof. Tear it up.
when they did that, he said that the Bible said when they had broken through, hallelujah. I love the word breaking through. You'll get your breakthrough today. In the name of Jesus. It says when they had broken through, they let down the bed which the paralytic was lying. This was a great adventure of faith. So they tied rope to this man, four places, and begin to lower him in from the roof. From the roof, begin to lower him in. And the Bible says in verse 5, when Jesus saw their faith, he said to the paralytic, son, your sins are forgiven you. That was another way Jesus healed people. He said, you are healed. Or he said, your sins are forgiven you. Amen. Jesus was amazed. Say, what? Desperate faith. They tore the roof in the midst of the crowd. They lowered that man. Amen. Say, son, your sins are forgiven you. It's equivalent to saying you are healed when he saw their faith. Then people started grumbling. Who is this one that they have power to forgive sin? So go to Mark chapter 2 from verse 10. It said, but that you may know that the Son of Man has power on earth to forgive sins. Amen. He now said it again. He said to the paralytic in verse 11, I say to you, arise, take your bed and go to your house. That means he's saying what? Today is your day. Your story has changed. I see someone's story changing today in Jesus' name. Say, your story has changed. What happened in verse 12? The Bible says, immediately. Hallelujah. Your situation is changing immediately. 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 In verse 12, the Bible says, immediately he what? Arose. The man jumped up. He arose. He took up his bed and went out in the presence of them all. Amen. He went out in the presence of them all. That means everyone that has seen you without shame and reproach, they will see you with your new status. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. With your new healing. Say, so he went out in the presence of them all, so that all were amazed and glorified God, saying, we have never seen anything like this. Amen. That is the same way we're saying about you. We have never seen anything like this. When the hand of God comes upon you, it is coming upon you right now. Men will say, we have never seen anything like this. Amen. So I decree a change in your situation. I decree a change in your situation. You might be financially sick. That is, poverty is a sickness also. The spiritual sickness. So in Jesus' mighty name, the power of God goes forth right now, and your situation is being changed. And when you are transformed, men will say, we have never seen anything like this. Hallelujah. So that was a good story. You see that? But what happened there? There was a demonstration of what? Faith. By these four men. By the people that brought that man. They tore the roof. The crowd was too much. They didn't just wait. They were not just watching. So sometimes you must do what? You must run after your miracle in a desperate measure. Sometimes you have to show the Lord that you want it so badly. Amen? Now let's look at Mark. We'll go to Mark chapter 3 from verse 8 to 10. And Jerusalem and Idumea and beyond Jordan and from Tyre and Sidon. Is that a great multitude when they heard how many things he was doing. Who was doing? Jesus was doing. He was healing the sick. They said from all over three towns together. They heard all the many things he was doing. They came to him. That's how men will begin to seek you. That's how men will begin to come to you. When they hear what God is doing with you. So they came to him. So he told his disciples that a small boat should be kept ready for him because of the multitude. Amen? Because of the crowd. Put a small boat aside. To do what? To check out after the service. Amen? So put a small boat by the side. Lest they should crush him. Look at the crowd. In verse 10 it says, for he healed many. For he healed many. That same Jesus is healing you right now. That same Jesus is healing you also. Your case is not an exemption. In the name of Jesus. The Bible says, so that as many as had afflictions pressed about him to touch him. You see, that was a quote. A pressing force. A pressing force is a demonstration of what? Our faith. They said, as many as had affliction press about him to do what? To touch him. Amen? Why? Because the power was flowing from his garment. That was the secret of the woman of the issue of blood. So from this woman's testimony, they now knew that the secret was what? In the garment. So they went after that garment to touch him also, to draw power. And what did the Bible say in verse 11? It says, and the unclean spirits. Jesus was empowered beyond measure. The Bible says, unclean spirits, whenever they saw him, they fell down before him and cried out, saying, says, you are the Son of God. So demons saw him and screamed. Amen? That is now when they see you, they'll begin to take off. In the mighty name of Jesus, because of the anointing of God that is working upon your life. It says, they saw him and screamed. They say, you are the Son of God. That is how the enemy will be recognizing you. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. You know, before I used to get bothered, I go to some places and people just get so offended. But I've never seen it, I've never crossed paths before. And the Lord used to tell me, he says, don't worry. It's not you that they see. It is me in you. Hallelujah. Say hallelujah. So in the wicked world, we must walk in the power and in the anointing of God. Amen. The anointing will clear way for you. Clear the road for you. When they see you, they will take off. Amen. So from today, you enter into a town, all darkness must take off for you. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Let us press forward in Mark chapter 3 from verse 13. I'll go to verse 14. He appointed 12 that they might be with him. From verse 13 says he went to the mountain. Ooh, he was charging that power with prayer. He was charging that power with prayer. He was charging it. Then he called those he wanted, he himself wanted, they came to him. And so he went and he prayed for it. He got the disciples. Then he appointed 12 that they might what? Be with him. And that he might send them out to preach. Hallelujah. Did you see that? Then in verse 15 he says, not just to preach. Verse 15 says, and to have what? Power to heal what? Sicknesses and cast out demons. Hallelujah. People say, oh, Jesus, it's only Jesus and the apostles that could do this. No. That same power, it calls you today, empowered by the Holy Spirit. He said, go out and preach, and to have what? Power to heal sicknesses. Amen? So he's healing you for, he's healing you right now, to heal sicknesses and to cast out demons. Hallelujah. Amen? And to cast out demons. So there's power available. Amen? And Mark chapter 6 from verse 12 to 13. It says, and they went out and preached that people should repent. Amen? The same way we're telling people today, we're telling you, say, Jesus is coming home. The Master is coming home. You need to repent. But not just tell them to repent. As you go, you meet the sick ones also. Heaven is at hand. Get ready for the kingdom. The kingdom of heaven is at hand. Repent for the kingdom of heaven. So the same way, he said, people should repent, change their ways. In verse 13, and it said, even as they were telling people, they said, they cast out many demons. So demons have met them on the way. Say, get out of here, you demons. Come out of him, you demons. They cast out many demons and anointed with oil many who were sick and healed them. So the anointing oil is another healing medium. Amen. They anointed with oil many who were sick, and the Bible says, and it healed them. Why? Because the Holy Spirit also flows into the anointing oil. That is also another medium, apart from laying on our hand. Amen? And the demons left them, and they became what? Healed. They became healed. Mark chapter 6, verse 54. Mark chapter 6, verse 54 says, "And when they came out of the boats, immediately the people recognized him." The people recognized him, ran through the whole surrounding region. That's how they'll be running after you. Amen? They ran through the whole surrounding region and began to carry about on beds those who were sick to wherever they heard he was. So they recognized him. That's the same again, oh. That is Jesus. So he's coming again. They begin to run. Begin to run ahead of him. They cried on beds, those who were sick, wherever they heard he was. And the Bible says in verse 56, wherever he entered into villages, cities, or countries, they laid the sick in the marketplaces. Amen? They laid the sick in the marketplaces and begged him that they might just touch the hem of his garments. And the Bible says, and as many as touched him were made well. Amen? As many as touched him were made well. He's available for you to touch him today. You can touch him also with your faith. You can touch him also with you believing. You can touch him also by the word. By the word of God. As you read it and you believe it. And he comes inside you and flushes all that sickness and disease. I see it happening in your life in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. 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 Let's jump to Mark chapter 7, verse 32. The Bible says they brought to him, this is another case. They brought to him one who was deaf and had this impediment in his speech. What's the impediment in his speech? Couldn't talk very well. And he was deaf also. So he had two problems. Could not hear, could not talk. And one thing we found out that a child that cannot hear will probably not be able to talk properly also. Because a child has learned to talk from what they hear, from the surrounding. Amen? So this boy was deaf and dumb. He took him from the multitude. He put his finger in his ears. He spat and touched his tongue. What a strange way to heal somebody. But Jesus knows everything. Hallelujah. Jesus took him out. He spat, touched his tongue. Verse 34 says, then, looking up to heaven, he sighed and said to him, Ephatha, that is, be opened. Be opened. Be opened. The same way I speak to your situation. Be opened.
Amen.
Be opened.
Amen.
By the word of God. Be opened.
Amen.
The Bible says in verse 35, immediately his ears were opened. Immediately your situation is changing also.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
By the word of the Lord. It says, immediately his ears were opened. And the impediment of his speech was loosed, and he spoke plainly. That is how your situation is changing also.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
I speak the word of God into your life. Be open and be loosed.
Amen.
Be set free. Fulfill your destiny.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Now look at Mark chapter 7 verse 37. The Bible says, they were astonished beyond measure. Change came. Change is coming your way. Change is coming your way.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Change is coming your way.
Amen.
They were astonished beyond measure. People will be astonished beyond measure at what God will do in your life. Saying,
Amen.
He has done all things well. Everything that's not well in your life, we decree. I decree it well.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
He has done all things well. He makes both the deaf to hear and the mute to speak. Amen? So everything deaf and dumb in your life, receive life now in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Receive life now in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Be loosed.
Amen.
Amen. Mark chapter 8, verse 22, 22 to 27. He came to Bethesda. They brought him a blind man and begged him to touch him. So now they now need the secret of power. They begged him to touch him. He took the blind man by the hand and let him out of the town. He didn't do it there. He said, come, let's go out first. So sometimes you need to change your environment. Maybe that is the source of your problem. He said, he led him out of the town. And when he had spat in his eyes and put his hands on him, he asked him if he saw anything. He looked up and said, I see men walking. Then he put his hands on his eyes again and made him look up, and was restored and saw as clearly as before. Hallelujah. A blind man came. Amen. A blind man came. He took him out of the town. And he said, look up. The man received his healing. The man received his healing. You are receiving your healing also. By the word of the Lord. In the name of Jesus. You are receiving your healing also. In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. What does it take to receive your healing? You must believe. Mark chapter 16, verse 16. He who believes and is baptized will be saved. You must believe in the healer. He carries all power. The Bible says in Mark, Luke chapter 1, verse 37, say, with God, nothing will be impossible. With God, nothing will be impossible. Your case is not impossible with God. In Jesus' mighty name, your case is not impossible. Luke 1:45, blessed is she who believed. Blessed is she who believed. There will be a fulfillment of those things which are told her from the Lord. As you believe the word of the Lord, you are receiving your healing.
Amen.
You are receiving your breakthroughs.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
He says there will be a fulfillment. She's going to get it.
Amen.
He's going to get it.
Amen.
What do you have to do? Believe. Everyone say believe. 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 Say I believe.
I believe.
I believe.
I believe.
I believe. I believe the word of God.
Every spirit of
unbelief be cast out now.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Luke 4:32. They were astonished at his teaching. For his word was with authority. He was not a weak teacher. He taught with power and authority. Power and authority. Amen? So Luke 4:35 from 34. Let's look at Luke chapter, let's look about Luke chapter 4 from 34. Demons saw him again. They said, leave us alone, let us alone. What have we to do with you, Jesus of Nazareth? Even the demons could recognize him. They said, leave us alone. What do we have to do with you? Did you come to destroy us? I know who you are. The Holy One of God. Look at the word holy there. It says, I know who you are. The Holy One of God. Leave us alone. Have you come to destroy us? I say every demons in your life need destroyed now.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
By the word of God.
Amen.
They are being destroyed now.
Amen.
Verse 35, Jesus rebuked him, saying, be quiet and come out of him. He told the demon, no negotiation with demons. No negotiation. He never had a conversation with them. Come out. He gave, all he did was give command. And when the demon had thrown him in their midst, before it came out, it threw the boy in their midst. It came out of him and did not hurt him. Verse 36, they were all amazed and spoke among themselves, saying, what a world this is. Amen? What a world this is. For with authority and power, he commands the unclean spirits and they come out of him. What a world this is. That same word is coming your way.
Amen.
That same word is coming your way.
Amen.
That same word is liberating you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The Bible says he sent his word and it healed them of their destructions. That same word is coming your way and is healing you. In the name of Jesus. Say, he commands your unclean spirits and they come out. They are coming out of you now. They are coming out of you now. Come out in Jesus' name. They are coming out of you now. In Jesus' mighty name. In Luke chapter 4, from verse 38, he arose from the synagogue and entered Simon's house. Simon's mother-in-law was sick with high fever. And they made requests of him concerning her. He stood over her and he rebuked the fever. He stood over her and rebuked the fever. The Bible says, and it left her. And immediately she arose and served him. In verse 40, the Bible says, when the sun was setting, all who had any that was sick, all who had any that was sick with various diseases brought them to him, and he laid his hand on every one of them. The Bible says, and healed them. So when Simon was at Peter's house, the mother was sick with high fever. Hallelujah. The mother was sick with high fever. He stood over her and he rebuked the fever. And the Bible says, all who had anyone that was sick, they brought all to him, and he laid his hands on every one of them and healed them. But what I was saying, demons also, he didn't just heal them, demons were running out. Demons also came out of many, crying out and saying, you are Christ, the Son of God. He rebuked them, did not allow them to speak, for they knew he was Christ. Amen? They knew he was Christ. Luke chapter 5 verse 15. However, the report went around concerning him all the more. So the news kept traveling and traveling and traveling and traveling. Concerning him all the more, great multitudes came together to hear. There's a hearing first before the healing. Great multitudes came and to be healed by him of their what? Infirmities. What's another word for infirmity? Sickness. 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 So no more sickness in your body. No more sickness. No more sickness. Jesus is visiting you today. No more sickness.
Amen.
No more sickness.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The power of God is available. So say, Pastor, can I be healed? First of all, you must know the will of God for you is to be healed. You must understand why Jesus came. He came. In Psalm 103, verse 2 and 3. The Bible says he came, he forgives, you know, he says he healed, he forgives us iniquities and heals all our diseases. You must understand God's will for you, that he has a plan for you to be healed. That is the very first step. God didn't create you to die of sickness. God didn't create you to be sick. God is not punishing you with sickness. You must know that it is your covenant right to have good health. That is step one. So when you see sickness, you must know that this is illegal. Amen. The Bible, Jesus says, it is finished. And he has paid the price. He has paid the price for your health. So anything short of good health is illegal. Then you begin to press into the word. You must know the word of God for you. You must be able to identify the word in the scriptures and see the picture of you and see that it might be, you might, the Bible also says it might be impossible with man, but with God all things are possible. then you look beyond science. You look beyond what the doctors have said. As the Bible says, whose report would you believe? Whose report would you believe? Say, who has the arm of God been revealed to? Say, I will believe God, though. I will believe my Creator. I will believe my Father. I know that with Him, nothing is impossible. Hallelujah. So believe the word of God. Exercise your faith. Grab those scriptures. Meditate on them. Begin to believe. Then you must walk by faith. Act by faith. When you take the word of God in, you begin to act like it has already happened. You begin to act like it has already happened. You know, you believe first before you receive. Don't try to receive first before you believe. That's where we miss it. Amen? The Bible says, the just shall live by faith. Listen to me. Do not try to receive first before you believe. You must act like it has already happened. And when you act like it has happened, God will stretch it. Believe first and receive. And begin to act it. Faith is an act. 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 You begin to act like it has happened already. It has happened. I am healed. 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 You begin to celebrate your healness. You say, how far was your illness? You say, God has done it. Hallelujah. You say, God has done it. God has done it. And that same God will not allow you to be disgraced. Do not look at what your physical eyes see. He will not allow you to be disgraced. You have announced His name. You say, I am healed in the name of Jesus. I am healed. It has been done. My finances have been healed. Everything has been healed. My body has been healed. My mind has been healed. My sickness has been healed. My emotions have been healed. What is your sickness? Say, take it. Take it now. Take it. Receive it. Say, I'm healed. The situation has changed. And stay in that joyful mode. Stay in joy. Because the devil visits people through depression. You must be joyful to receive your healing. You must be joyful to stay healed. Take it, ask it, live it. Speak it. Speak the word. Release your faith by speaking. Not just in your heart. First from your heart, then speak it out. That God has healed me. You follow the steps. Satan will not be placed, will not be able to place anything on you again. And finally, walk in love. Walk in love to maintain your healing. Walk in love. Forgive all those that have offended you. Forgive. That He may forgive you also. Forgive those that have offended you. Some of you, your miracle is, your door is closed because of unforgiveness. Forgive so that your miracle, the door will be open for your miracle to come in. For God to be able to come into your heart. For He does not reside where there is bitterness, strife, unforgiveness. No. He checks out from there. So forgive so He can come into your heart. Finally, which is step one, you must be a child of God. You must accept Jesus into your life. You must say, Lord, I receive you. You are the Son of God. Come into my heart. I want to be your child. The Bible says that the bread of God is for the family. It's not for outsiders. The Bible says not to say scrolls, it's for dogs. But you must eat the real bread, which is His word. So come into the kingdom. Come into the kingdom. Stay a child of God. Stay healthy. How do you do that? Accept Jesus Christ in your life. And how do you keep Jesus in your life? You must live a holy life. You must live a sanctified life. You must live a purified life. You live like that, Satan cannot touch you. Satan cannot put nothing on your body. He's the one that runs around and afflicts people. So live a holy life. He said, son, your sins are forgiven. That's what He told that man. That means that because of your sickness, sin was the entry or how it came in. Now I've forgiven your sin. So He says, sin no more. He told someone, he says, sin no more, lest what? A worse thing comes upon you. So you live a holy life and you shut down the door of Satan. You let Satan in when we sin. So you live a holy life. You keep Jesus in you by living sanctified. So I pray a prayer for those that need healing of God. Say after me, say, Father, I accept you today as the Son of God. Forgive me of my sins. Come into my heart. Come into my heart. Those that you don't know Jesus, say, Jesus, I accept you today. Come into my heart. I believe your word. You are the Son of God. Write my name in the book of life, Lord. Write my name in the book of life. Count me worthy as make me a candidate of heaven. And Lord, I release your Holy Spirit to go forth right now by the power of God that has already gone forth, the word of God that has gone forth, and your Holy Spirit that is gone right now. Heal every sickness. Heal every sickness. Fear, I bind it, I cast it out now, in the name of Jesus. Let your children have peace with the economy, whatever is going on. Let your peace touch every heart now. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. You are blessed. You are blessed. And stay healed in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.